So as we begin, our message affirmation today is, I am one with all in spirit. This is an important thing, and we talk about this a lot in New Thought and in our fellowship and in unity and in so many faith traditions around the world, the fact that we are all one in spirit. A wonderful reminder of this is to take the time to read through the scriptures. I know, you know, this is a big book and it's very complex and it can be hard to get through and there's lots of messages. But if we focus on the Gospels, those four first easy books, those are not as challenging as the whole Bible. And we learn so much about the life of Christ, our way shower. And indeed, in this way, we can become so much more connected with him in the way that he lived his life and the way that we know as truth seekers and truth students that we seek to live our own lives. And this day of all days is a wonderful day because we're talking about Father's Day. And Father's Day is a wonderful day to celebrate all of us who had a wonderful, loving father that brought us up. And we had people who played the role of mother and father and did both things. And regardless of all that, the Creator, the Almighty Father, was always present, always present. I find it so interesting that if I wanted to sell tacos on the corner, I've got to go and I got to get a permit to do it. If I want to drive a car, well, thank God they make you get a license for that, because some of the ways some of these people drive, you wonder how on earth did they pass that test. But anyways, you know, because this is an old joke, you know, you got to get a driver's license to drive a car. You don't need any kind of anything to have a child, to become a father. It doesn't come with, you know, they don't release you. If you're lucky, you get released from the hospital, maybe with a manual that tells you how to feed your child and how to keep your baby warm. They don't say, and you know what, for their spiritual growth, do this, and to make sure that they do everything morally correct, do this, and to make sure that they never get in trouble, do this and this. And of course, the really brilliant parent could go out and buy a mountain of books, because there are mountains of books, because there's so many people out there telling you how to raise your child, and usually half of them don't have their own children, but they're experts on telling you how to raise your child. You'll find that a lot in life. We know that the reality is, the way that most children learn and grow and become the grown, adult, responsible, loving people they are is through the demonstration of the leadership that they have with them. And that generally is the parent. So you, the leadership, you demonstrate the ways in which you are to live and to live appropriately and to be a good person and a loving person and a generous person and a caring person and a responsible person and all the wonderful attributes in life that we want people to, that we want our children to be as parents as we watch them grow up and we want them to be successful. And we, more than anything we do, it's through demonstration. I can't tell you how many times I've heard the joke about, you know, the parent scolding the child about doing something, you know, stop smoking, it's no good for you, it's going to stunt your growth. But you do it. Well, that's different, because I'm the adult. So it definitely is by example. And so we, of course, now, I'm not, you know, we're not, we're all above the age of being children, but of course, we're all the children of God, and we're all, as we like to consider ourselves in New Thoughts, we're all students. We're all students. And so as we go through this process of this thing that we call life, we know that for guidance, for leadership, we have the scriptures to turn to. We know that that is the demonstration of how we as adults are to live our lives in all things, in all things. And so when Reverend Virginia was reading the New Testament positive scripture reading today, it was from Philippians 2:4. And of course, this is not the Gospels, but the New Testament is filled with the Gospels as well as all the letters that Paul wrote to the various churches he was establishing as he went all around establishing all these Christian churches, and to help them out and make sure they were in line, he would write them letters. He's explaining to them things just like what I'm talking about today, how Christ was the example to be lead, just like we as children look up to our parents, our mothers and our fathers, to be the example of life. So when Paul writes to the Philippians and he says to them, look not every man on his own things, but every man also on the things of others, like I said, he's not necessarily, don't get nosy and get in your neighbor's business. But, you know, don't sit here eating steak and, you know, the finest of vegetables and see that your neighbor is grubbing in the dirt for something to eat when there's something you can do. He is referring to the fact that it was Christ's way to be on the lookout and to look after every man as you look after your own self. If you're doing well, make sure that those around you are doing well. And then, of course, you will be risen. And we know that this is the message that Christ, the way shower, shared with us. We know that Christ, who we consider the way shower, because we know that his life was indeed filled and was perfect, spiritual, and divine in all ways, that he was the way shower. And so when I encourage people to read the Gospels after you've done that, if you have the time, and this is great, read through the letters that Paul wrote, because that is the greater thing, because it's when certain questions would arise and Paul would write back. And a lot of times he would write in parables somewhat as Christ did. So sometimes you've really got to put on your thinking hat. You know, some of this stuff isn't meant to take literally. I love the term how we talk about our United States Constitution as a living, breathing document. So indeed is this book, because it grows with us. And it changes, because as things change in our world, certainly they didn't have Facebook back when they were putting together, you know, these different books and said, you know what, we're going to choose all these books and make this Bible. They didn't have social media. They didn't have automobiles, for heaven's sakes. They didn't have half the things. And so they couldn't have predicted. But the messages in here are lifelong. That are lifelong, no matter how technologically advanced we become or what we can or can't do or how many times we can go to the moon or if we can go and build cities on the moon or Mars, whatever, all of this is still going to apply. It's going to be relevant. It's always going to be relevant because we know that Christ is the way shower. And just as your mother and your father were showing you the way through demonstration as you were growing up, we know that this is the place to go for our own inspiration, for our own demonstration of how to live lives of great happiness, great health, and great prosperity that we know our Creator has in mind for us. The goal for the week, and we like to have a goal for the week, and of course, try really hard this week and then see how well you reap the rewards, because we know that there are these universal laws, just like the gravity and the centrifugal force is what's keeping this little ball of dust here in this little speck of nothing and all this vastness and greatness out there that our Creator made. Just as we know that the universal law is going to make sure that the sun is going to rise and set tomorrow, we know that these universal laws of prosperity and love and the various things we talk about, they are just as true. They are just as true. So the goal for the week is look not only after your own well-being, but that of others, but that of others. And of course, we talk about this frequently, and you know, I'm not saying put yourself in the poorhouse because you know somebody else next to you, but I think that we all have something that we can give. And sometimes it's just a helping hand, a smile, just a few minutes to sit and let somebody unburden the challenges that they're going through. Listen to them talk, because therapists are like $150 an hour. So, you know, that there is like a free $150 gift to sit and let a friend share a challenge with you. And even if you just say, because I'm convinced that's the only phone conversations my mother ever had when I was growing up, because that's all I heard from our aunt. I know. And she'd hang up. But, you know, she was providing this kind of comfort and solace. And it's interesting, I didn't grow up New Thought. We grew up in very fundamental, but she was always a Daily Word subscriber. And so we always had the Daily Word. And as I grew and I was an adult, the first few years after I moved from home, she had sent me gift subscriptions. And, you know, I would read it, but I didn't have the understanding that I do today. But it's been there. It's been a part of us. So even way back then, before I knew that this was going to be such a big focus of my life, parts of it were already expressing themselves to me. And so, of course, by example. And the good news is that we are all one in spirit. As we are all one in spirit, then we too should be one on our path in life, so that as we look to our own well-being, we look as well to the well-being of those in the world around us. Just as the Father looks to the well-being of his children, we too can be Christ-like in our daily lives. These are the elements that create for us our divine world of great happiness, great health, great prosperity, great love, and great peace. And these are absolutely all of our things to claim. These things are there for all of us to claim, each and every one of us. All right, I'd like to invite you to join me in prayer now. Eternal and divine spirit, we thank you so much for your wonderful gifts. We thank you for giving us in written form so that we could decipher this wonderful life of Christ, so that we do indeed have a role model to build our lives on and build our lives after, so that we can indeed live lives of great happiness and great health and great prosperity, as we know you, our great creator, had planned for us. We thank you for these gifts and for all gifts. We thank you, eternal and loving spirit. Amen.